teams have won their last two contests of the year. Both teams trying to prep for heading into the playoffs.
Big games can step into this one here because, you know, it's kind of games for both of them. St. John's kind of on the bubble a little bit. You know, Finley with an opportunity to really solidify their playoff berth. You know, Finley three-game winning streak right now, you know, averaging about 44 points a game in that streak as well, you know. So, but then St. John's also with a two-game winning streak coming into this game. And so it's going to be a key matchup, a couple great quarterbacks out there. It's going to be, you know, they may blow up the scoreboard whenever night, you know, with those two out there. But, you know, it'll be interesting to see what they do.
The Philly Trojans come in at 4-4. They are 3-2 in the track. St. John's Jesuit Titans, they are 3-5, but they are also 3-2 in the track. How about keys to the game, Dark?
Let's look at St. John's first, the visiting team coming in here to Donnell Stadium. You know, one of the things they need to do is they have to have some strong secondary play and linebacker play. You know, Montgomery, the Finley quarterback, comes in. He's got like a three or four games this year of six touchdowns per game. You know, he throws a lot. He throws accurate. So they got to have a good secondary and linebacker play out there. They also got to put pressure on Montgomery. They can't allow him to sit back here in the pocket. The problem is they got Dallas De La Cruz back there, too, running the ball for Finley. So you can't put too much pressure on Montgomery and give up on that kid. And the last thing is you got to hold your positions. You got to know where you want to be, and you got to stay there. You can't let these guys get you out of position because they'll burn you on the outside. They'll burn you on the inside. So you got to hold your positions. Let's look at Finley then. You know, when they come in here against the St. John's team, and we talked about all the athletes out there, the biggest one for St. John's is their quarterback, Blake Lichtenberg. I mean, coming in here, he's the younger brother of Blake Lichtenberg, University of Cincinnati quarterback, and he's put up some really impressive numbers this year. So you got to concentrate on him because he can single-handedly beat you if you let him. You know, so you got to put pressure on him as well. You know, and then you want to get off to a quick start if you're Finley. You don't want to have to come from behind on these guys. You want to just get out there, get some points on the board early on, put the pressure on them to have to come back in this game. And the last thing is, you know, you talk about Lichtenberg, but you got to keep an eye on that Lovett kid out there too, the running back for St. John's. I mean, he puts some metal to it as well. So you want to get on him too and just kind of contain him as much as you can. Make Lichtenberg your sole priority, really, but contain the other kid.
Thank you for that, Dog. And the last 10 matchups between these two teams, St. John's has a 6-4 advantage. Talk about offense. The winning team has averaged 42 points in those 10 games. The losing team has averaged 26.4. We could be well for a shootout type game this evening. That's our pregame show. It's been presented by Lima Chevrolet Cadillac, the area's premier Chevrolet and Cadillac dealer in the greater Lima area. The kickoff comes up next. You're watching High School Football on WOSN.
There and a lot of targets out there you can throw to too. You know, that's that's one of the things your secondary for Portland's got to be aware of. They got to get out there on those guys because they can get out there and play some long ones if you let them. Tucker Oliver right there on him too, you know, little pass over the middle there, a couple guys, you know, converging on him. Breaking up both those passes. With some big receptions for him, 6 touchdowns coming in, you know, 28 catches, over 480 yards. But he's a load back there, 240 pounds, man. He's a little low to the ground. He's going to just pound into you as much as he can all night long. You got to be prepared for that.
And at that 6 foot, there's not much room to hit.
No, there's not.
240 pounds back there.
You're not going to hit him unless you hit him low and take his legs out from under him. You're not going to be able to knock him down.
Lovett got 3 on first down.
Yeah, I don't even think the receiver turned around in time for that one because it was fired right away, and he was still making his motion downfield.
The bird has tossed several passes rather quickly in the route here in the opening drive. He is currently 1-4. That kind of a first down.
Well, you got to give him credit. He's not afraid to throw into crowds either. Because all of them have been right in the crowd. About his defense all week long, you know, as far as the, you know, progression that they've made. You know, they're giving up 30.5 points a game, but in the last few games, in the last 3 winning streak games, they've only given up 26 points a game, so they're really starting to buckle down. Decent field position, see what your offense can do, and believe me, you've got an offense led by one of the top quarterbacks in the league. Play right out of St. John's playbook from the first drive. I mean, right over the middle, right, you know, having the guy break right through in the middle. This time, though, Montgomery was able to find him and just hit him right on the numbers.
8-yard pickup, 37.
Last week in their win, you know, 262 yards, I believe, in the game last week, four, you know, two touchdowns. But Ralph Worthy was right there to pog him down.
Five receiver pattern this time. It's 32. Quick out. Tried to get it down here to Reese Little. Little was played fairly well by Justin Tower.
That was perfect timing for him. Just hit the receiver just as the ball hit his hand. Just kind of feeling themselves out a little bit here, but you know, Lichtenberg has just been a little bit off on his passes, you know, a little bit too quick on the inside passes and just overthrew his, you know, receiver on the outside pass. Montgomery, you know, decent job, you know, coming down, you know, but they just couldn't get anything going on the run game to get them anything, even a first down. At least St. John's got some first downs in their first possession, but let's see what they can do on their second possession if Finley's defense can hold.
On their own 36-yard line.
And Yeager there on the tackle.
And I love seeing that play on first down.
Just put it back to the 39-yard line. They call it a pickup of 3 minutes.
He's a 240-pound load right there, and you can see what he does with the ball. After he broke through that line and got into the secondary there, he just buried his head right down and just pulled forward. And you're not going to tackle him one-on-one if you're a cornerback back there, that's for sure. You need some help.
So you need bank first down. Two carries by 11, 14 yards, and then he gets the yard line.
That's a nice looking sweep around too, and he had some blocking up in front of him.
Yards. I mean, right there, you know.
Defense has been, for lack of words, you know, they bend a lot, you know, they break sometimes, other times they look great and they hold. So let's see what they do on this possession here. But then flopped up at the end by big number 55, Luke Montgomery. Montgomery just wrapped him up in a bear hug and said, no way are you getting that first down.
They are just inside the 25-yard line. They need to get just inside the 24.
By the quarterback on that one there, just walking forward, knew where he had to go and just kept pushing forward, got a nice push by his offensive line and caught it right up.
Actually got 11 all the way down to the 14-yard line. Just drive the game 3 minutes ago back on the 14-yard touchdown run, his fifth of the season.
I tell you what, Mark, he was dead to rights back here. Or looked like maybe dropped for a loss. He was able to shake that tackle off and then just maneuvered around two or three defenders just to get to the end zone.
Right here, look what he did on a nice play of the drive. He gets into the end zone. That's a 64-yard drive. And it's the DAT attempt. They've used two different players this year. This is Nick Miller, 16 of 17, is the junior.
much on their first possession, but, you know, this is a very explosive offense that can really, you know, put a lot of yardage on the, you know, on the board real quick. Put 201 pounds, but it's a big front line there for Cleveland St. John.
It is. Lost a draft a half a yard. Receivers to the right this time. Remember, behind the ball, we're going to throw a deep to get a guy open. And it's ticked off. Making a great play on the football. It was Cruz. Deeper to Cruz up the sideline. Still running. And finally gets back out of bounds.
Ball just underthrown just enough that the defender was able to prick that off and made a nice run down the right sideline. Tough play there for the Finley Trojans.
Cruz, he just kind of sat back there and waited. As you said, the ball was a bit underthrown.
Interception thrown by Ryan Montgomery.
St. John's in great position.
As he just kind of glides his way down the field and has guys missing him.
A little bit anxious to mark that first down.
He just sailed it a little bit high. Job. When you got a running quarterback, you know, that can scramble and so forth, you know, it's tough for you to get your linemen because they want to keep and hold their blocks and stuff, but then they think you're going to take off running, and then all of a sudden they're on the wrong side of the ball.
Well, they never marked off the penalty. Here we go.
Get up to the line of scrimmage. I think, too, because there was a receiver open again for St. John across that line. Finley off guard a little bit, you know, a little flat-footed. Nate Regal made a nice job of recovering.
Second down.
Good job by the turtle.
That's a nice tackle that time by Tucker Oliver. He leads his team in tackle for losses. That would be a loss right there. Back to the
Oliver did a great job pursuing down the line, watching where that guy, the running back, was going to go, and, you know, able to pull him down, and he held his ground and just, you know, wouldn't allow him to get past him.
Third down, goal to
quarterback, you know, like, listen, it's tough if you're an offensive lineman, you know, to hold your positions and not hold because you're trying to run with your quarterback and keep him in front of him. What a huge, huge penalty that is, though. Well, that's a big one, too. That's a huge blow for the St. John offense because that's their leading X receiver right out there.
Fourth and goal from the 19, facing the Titans. The throw to the end zone. It's caught and brought down before he gets to the end zone. The pass was caught by Justin Tyler. Comes up just short. And Finley holds. Thanks for the penalty and some good defense.
Wow. Great job by Finley. did a good job. Just, you know, from the guy who's coming down there, even that pass there, he can go top and be able to pull it down. Shoot the finish right there for him. Carry the ball. He's got about 261 yards for the season. He hasn't run as much as he did this year. Thank you.
We'll be right back. Thank you. Yeah.
bullet, boy. I'll tell you what. It'll be huge for them going into the second half because right now they just all the momentum on St. John's side.
Thank you.
everybody coming back here. In the end, there wasn't anybody that was going to be coaching.
That is good.
Thank you. important decision. And they got points, and that was a big thing. And so they get the ball and start knocking something out. So they see what they know. They can use that momentum, let that drive, and carry it over into the second half.
Certainly will. And, you know, just getting, like we talked about, getting that 3 points to end the first half, what you have been, really haven't been able to move the ball that well. You had a couple of interceptions thrown. Things just weren't clicking. They weren't rhythm the first half. And then be able to come down and drop down, at least get points in the fourth. You know, the confidence builder, you know, against what's really been a St. John's game so far. So I see if Finley can put something together here to start the second half. So he's had to do it with his feet. And St. John's put a lot of pressure on him.
Dallas got to produce. We'll get the handoff. And like, he'll attempt to run through and tackle him. A big hit.
Yeah.
so much. You know, St. John's putting a lot of pressure on him, getting a lot of, you know, guys in the backfield.
Chris Rutten took the receiver to the left, recovered a look, but he had a great reputation up on the field. Julie goes, and he was fine again. This time he gets over the last time. I don't care. He can't attempt that time. It's going to be tall on the third down.
On this one, I
the inside, passes to the outside.
Thank you.
team that gives up 20 and a half points a game, you couldn't tell by this game here. Powered offense. He just hasn't figured out that St. John's defense up front. They haven't been able to open up any holes there to get Dale Cruz any running room. And just momentum killers on both sides. Yeah.
holes very effectively. His direction and come around the other end, and he's got the speed to get out there. And a couple blockers still there on the front of him.
so far in the first three quarters, 301 yards of total offense to 177 for Finley. You know, both teams with 92 yards of penalties apiece. So a lot of flags thrown in this game so far, but really, you know, just Finley's just not been able to get anything really consistently going in this game.
Thank you.
thing for St. John's this game is just the pressure on Montgomery.
Thank you.
So you did. He knew exactly where you had to go. That's a tough one for Finley, too, because they really need to get it stopped. You know, this clock continues to run down. Up the plays. Slides down.
stop the quarterback for St. John's, and then they throw in the big guy, you know, Lovett as well. You know, it's just tough to stop them. St. John's, you look at the record, 3-5. You wonder how in the world is that?
Yeah.
It's a 3-5. I mean, this is not a 3-5 team.
Again, you started out with Dublin Cox, who was 10-2 before tonight. And Wayne was 7-1 before tonight. Perrysburg was 7-1 before that.
In there to do that right. Formation so you don't get anybody hurt.
Just
it certainly was. And Finley just not able to get in any kind of rhythm tonight. They just, you know, their offense just stuttered most of the night. They had a couple of plays. They did score, you know, late in the game. But, you know, they just couldn't put anything together. But give St. John's all the credit in the world. The game plan just worked. And the quarterback and the running back did what they had to do. And on their defense, just, you know, outstanding all night long. Their front line was just, you know, stopping the run of Finley and just getting in there and pressuring Ryan Montgomery all night.
They had a couple of interceptions, partly because of the way their defense played up front. Touchdown run by Lickie Burton early, then two touchdown passes at his strength. The extra points played off, but that gave them 18 points of field goal at the end of the half. And then a 65-yard drive and a 9-play system. That touchdown pass to Hasselbeck made the final score 18-10.
So it was.